Hey y'all, welcome back to the Browse Bunch, or welcome if you're new here. It's time for another grocery haul. This week we went to Walmart. Surprise, surprise! I just haven't been venturing out to any other stores and haven't really been couponing, so it's been Walmart pretty much every single week lately. This week though, you're actually gonna get two different grocery hauls from me. Today's is just our week's worth of groceries, and then tomorrow I've got a baking haul, and I'm filming them both today because I did it together, but tomorrow's is actually part of a collab that I'm doing, and I'm really excited about it because y'all know I love grocery hauls, so the more grocery hauls the better. But so I am in this video going to be sharing this week's worth of groceries. Everything together between this week's worth of groceries and the baking though was $165, and since I did it together, I don't exactly know how much just our groceries were. Pretty sure it was less than a normal $130 though, because I tried to, you know, balance it out a little bit since I was new that I was doing the baking too. So I am just sharing this week's worth of groceries for our family, and then also the meal plan at the end, and including the prices of everything, just not the actual grand total, because I don't exactly want to take the time to add it all up, so I'm sorry. But tomorrow you will get a baking haul, which will be exciting. I think I honestly got more baking supplies than I did groceries, because you know, I mean, I needed a lot of stuff to make a lot of goodies. So that will be exciting, and it will be up tomorrow, Tuesday, for you guys. So make sure you subscribe so you don't miss out, but let's get on into these groceries. So here are all of the groceries that we got for this week. I think another reason that I don't have as much is because there are a couple nights this week that Travis is gonna be working late, so I didn't want to do anything elaborate and just keep it simple for me and the kids, because we all know that they are picky eaters and would much rather eat like corn dog nuggets or chicken nuggets instead of an actual meal that I make. So we're just gonna keep it simple on those nights. We got some Velveeta mac and cheese. The boys like mac and cheese. I like mac and cheese. It's a win. We're gonna have that some. We got some smoked sausage, and we don't normally buy steaks. Like, I rarely get steaks because I'm really just honestly not a big fan of steaks. I've never liked the taste of it, but since I've been cooking a lot more, I've learned how to cook things to my liking a little bit. So we're gonna do some little steak pieces cooked up one night with some sides that I think is gonna be pretty good. So I did get some of that, and Travis is excited about it because he loves steak. Got some cheddar cheese, our usual 3-pound bag of apples. I did get some muffins. I like to just keep these on hand sometimes, and they came in handy, and we used them when our cousins were over for breakfast one morning. But we got some wild berry ones and chocolate chip ones. I like doing these like in the mini muffin pan because it's the perfect size for the kids to have a couple and not make as big of a mess, in my opinion. Porter has really been liking these oatmeal squares. We've had them in the pantry for a while, and I was eating them for a little bit, but then we had a few left over, and we were running out of some like snacks and groceries this week, I'll tell you. And he got desperate enough that he ate an oatmeal square, and he actually liked it. So I got a box of those. Picked up the boys some yogurt, this Moana kind that has 4 berry and 4 strawberry. Some mini corn dog nuggets. I usually get, you know, just normal corn dogs, but I thought it would be fun for them to have some mini ones. And our favorite broccoli that I like, the Tuscan seasoned broccoli. We got a random red pepper here that's actually for cornbread salad. Then some french fries, the thin cut ones. Thought this would be good to try out because, you know, kids love french fries, and we can kind of, you know, make our own happy meal, if you will, at home with some dino nuggets that actually have veggies in them. They have been eating so many of these lately, and I don't even feel bad about it because they got veggies in them. And then these are one, whoop! And then these are one of my favorite snacks. It's the Cheez-It Grooves sharp white cheddar. I could not talk, apparently. I decided to try out some of these Allen's Italian green beans that are actually already seasoned. Y'all know that I've been loving my smothered green beans, but Travis suggested just having some normal green beans lately. I don't know why, because those are just the best ever, but that's what we're gonna do. So I got some of the seasoned ones. For cracker snacks this week, we got the boys' favorite cheese ones, and then these I haven't gotten in a long time, but they're really good. It's the peanut butter and jelly kind. I don't know if you guys have tried those before, but they are good. The more chocolate milk. I did have to run to the store the other day just to get some stuff for some dips that I was making, so I actually already picked up a gallon of our regular milk. You know what I should have done? I should have done like a fill-in haul with that and just included it with this one. That would have been nice because, I mean, I got like probably $40 worth of groceries at least that night, so it would have been worth including. And I promise I don't usually do that. Like, we don't run to the store throughout the week very often, but because, I mean, I like just going once a week and saving as much money as we possibly can and just trying to find something that we already have in place of it, you know. But sometimes you just gotta do what you gotta do, because I needed some ingredients that I missed for the dips that I was making for that video that is coming out this week as well. And y'all, I'm really excited for you to see it, because we made 4 different dips and they were amazing. Like, seriously, Travis said he felt like he was at Applebee's or Fats or somewhere, sitting down ordering all the appetizers. It was awesome. We had so much fun.
The next thing I got were these Chewy Variety Pack granola bars, and I usually get, you know, the Quaker or whatever brand it is. And I don't know why I haven't tried the Great Value ones, but we got the Great Value ones to try this time. They still have the peanut butter chocolate chip, chocolate chunk, and then s'mores as well. So that's pretty much basically the same box that we would get with the Quaker ones. So definitely worth the try. I got 5 pounds of potatoes. I want to do some fried taters this week because I love them for a side for a meal. And then probably use some of them and make some homemade french fries in the air fryer sometime, either this week or next week, whenever I get around to it. And then the last things that I got was cereal. Got Porter some more Fruit Loops. He's been loving that, and he is our picky eater. I know I've mentioned that many times, but you couldn't even get him to eat cereal for the longest time. So the fact that he'll even eat Fruit Loops is kind of cool. But he is getting better about eating and trying new things, which is a huge win. I'm so excited about it. And then we got Grant's usual favorite, Honey Nut Cheerios, and I already had this in my buggy when I saw this on the end cap of an aisle, and it's the Pokemon cereal. I just thought that he would love it. That was totally an impulse buy, but figured it would make him smile. So it's got little Pikachus and lightning bolts in it, so I thought that would be really neat for him. So that is all of our week's worth of groceries this week. Now let me show you the meal plan. Okay, here is the meal plan. Just disregard the extra drawing on there. Porter got a hold of it, and he loves to draw on anything, anytime there's a pen or anything around. So Sunday, we're gonna do beans and cornbread. Sunday is today. That's one of my favorite simple go-to meals that I absolutely love, which is really funny because I hated it when I was a kid, and we had it often, but I never liked it until I got older. Monday was one of Travis's requests. He wanted smoked sausage. I wanted fried taters. Then I was like, what can we have with that? And he said smoked sausage and green beans, so that's what we're going to do. Tuesday and Wednesday are both those days that Travis is going to be working later. So Tuesday, we're just going to do a pizza night. We still got some frozen pizzas in the freezer. And then Wednesday is a fend for yourself night. Probably chicken nuggets and mac and cheese with fruit for the kids, and honestly, probably me too. Thursday will be a cheesy pesto chicken. Friday is takeout, and then Saturday will be those steak bites, cornbread salad, and mac and cheese. And I am excited for that one. Like I said, I don't usually like steak bites, but I'm hoping that we can make them to where I actually like the taste of them. You guys probably think it's crazy that I don't like steak, but my mom don't either. Well, no, that's actually the one thing that she does like. She doesn't like hamburgers or anything, and in between on that now. Like, I like some of them, so I'm hoping that's the same case with the steak. But growing up, we were kind of in the same boat. We didn't eat a lot of red meat and stuff, no hamburgers or anything like that. My dad and brother like them, but me and my mom didn't. Steak was the one thing that she would eat with A1 sauce, so thought that was funny. So that is going to be it for this grocery haul and meal plan. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and that you'll join me again tomorrow for tomorrow's baking haul, Christmas baking haul collab. It's going to be a lot of fun. If you did enjoy this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe down below if you're not already. But I will see you tomorrow in the baking haul. Bye, y'all.